Sometimes a group of cars and a location can be so compelling that you don't really need a reason to do anything. Today, though, we do have a reason for being here. We have three of the lightest and most exciting sports cars ever made. They're all British, they're all around the 40 grand mark, and they're about as exciting as motoring comes. And we are at Anglesey Circuit. Look around you. Is there a better location for a race circuit in the UK? Utterly beautiful day. 25 degrees, dry, a new track service. I mean, this is just motoring nirvana. The best weather we've had so far. £38,000 worth of Lotus 211. £38,000 worth of Caterham R500, the new R500 with the forward engine. And 2.5 grand with a sequential gearbox. So this is pretty exciting and new stuff for us. And over there, similarly, about 36 grand's worth of Ariel Atom 3 with a 300 horsepower supercharged engine. What we're going to try and achieve today is drive them lots, skid them lots, find out what their different personalities are, then do some lap times and find out which is quickest with my two new colleagues, Richard Meaden and Jethro Bovingdon, and then have a look round them and come to some summaries, but not absolute verdicts, because on initial impressions, these are three of the most special cars ever sold. This is Caterham getting back to doing what it does best. 263 horsepower, revs well over 8,000 RPM. A mental machine. That lever there does not go from side to side. A 6-speed sequential gearbox by Quaife on upshifts, just a little lift on the throttle and you can just bang the next gear in. Absolutely fantastic fun. It's riding on CR500s today, so you'd expect it not to be as quick as if it was on ACB10s, but then these can be used in the rain, no windscreen, and a fantastic colour scheme. Very excited by this thing. Again, I do believe this is Caterham getting back to what it does best. Dear, but God, it just is so well made, it's incredibly desirable. Lotus 211. Now, I was very cynical about this thing when it was launched. I just thought, another Elise chassis, why do they bother? Then I drove it and realised it's something very, very different to any other Lotus vehicle. Even a top spec Exige just doesn't have any of the agility and alertness of this car. And compared to the other two, technologically quite advanced as well. That big red thing there, that does your starting, but this knob here and this button, it's adjustable traction control. Now that is very, very handy for those of us who are less than superheroes. The middle pedal, could you look under there, would look quite ordinary as well, but this car has ABS. Now, in these paired back sports cars, you probably wouldn't think of ABS as being a great advantage, but my experience of this car is that the ABS is dead impressive. Not the best looking car I've ever seen. I always get the feeling that it looks like something sort of missing about here. Of course it's a windscreen, but I don't know, not the best result. Although I followed it over here, Richard Meaden was driving it and I followed it from low down in the Atom and it did look sinister and very, very special. So high hopes, although I would say that with 265 horsepower but a curb weight of 750 kilograms, its power to weight ratio, although relative to any other sports car, is very, very high, in this frankly very punchy company is quite low. So on lap time, will it suffer on the straights and what can it claw back in the braking zones and through the corners? Atom 3, this is my first exposure to this new car. Looks quite similar, but there are some changes in the whole chassis, and most notably of all is the way that they've isolated the engine from everything else. So it's got some proper bushing in there and you just don't feel it. Whereas the thing used to fizz and vibrate, you don't have that anymore. Light Dymag wheels. Again, we're on an Advan AO48, so it's the same tyre as the Lotus, but not the Lotus version, because obviously that's their own. It's a Bilstein damper, fully adjustable, although these adjustments actually combine a bump and a rebound adjustment, so you could say it's a bit limited in that respect, but it's still nice to have some adjustment. There's nothing really looks like an Atom, is there? In there is a UK spec Civic Type R engine that has been supercharged. They claim 300 horsepower. Tom from Atom, who's with us, has just reliably informed me that it's a bit more. Call it 315 and a heap of torque. So the power to weight ratio of this 520 kilogram car doesn't even bear thinking about, but if you're thinking in the 600 mark, it's around there. So like I said, no winners and losers because they're all pieces of art in our eyes, but let's answer a few questions about their differences. Okay, it's still sunny at Anglesey, and despite this not being too formal an exercise, we do need to find out which is the fastest car. We're not going to do that in the conventional way, however, because if we just got one person to drive all the cars and set a lap time, that would mean that one of us could be the hero and the other two couldn't be, and it doesn't really work like that. So we've devised this idea, okay, under the assumption that we're all as fast as each other. Richard and Jethro here, and myself, we all think, we've been pedalling about earlier, there's not much in it, is there?
Not great deal.
There's not a great deal in it. We think there might be some performance difference between the cars, but it's not as marked as you'd think. You'd think the Lotus would be a little bit slower, but it's got advantages in terms of its ABS brakes, and it is surprisingly quick through the quick corners as well, so it's not being held back. Caterham, very rapid. Atom, it's difficult to describe what it feels like in third and fourth gears. It's
scary,
yeah.
Perhaps.
What it needs is two of those wheelie bars out the back, because when it lights up in fourth, you think, going to take off. So what we're going to do is we're going to draw a name from a hat, and that's the car you've got to go and set your lap time in, and whoever sets the fastest time is the fastest bloke, which means they get office bragging rights and is also with the fastest car. So let's try that. Here we go. Out of the hat, please notice.
Who's first?
The Driver's Republic hat. Very proud of that, eh? We're going to choose these in order of the highest place finish at last year's Silverstone 24-hour race. Now, if I remember correctly, I came...
Second?
No, it was third, actually, but there we go. Okay. And where did you guys come?
15.
Overall.
15. Were you going to say first in
class?
First in class, right.
We were third. This sounds better.
Okay, right. So that means I get to choose first. Quite convenient. I'm going to choose that one there. Right.
Which is... Please be the Atom.
Yes. Don't be the Lotus, because I know it's fast, but it scares me in the fast corners.
Yes!
Lotus.
Right.
Lotus.
Jethro.
It's me now. I'm actually nervous.
Yeah.
By process of elimination.
Atom, which upside down like that spells Widowmaker. So, who goes first?
I suppose Jethro.
Yeah, Jethro, there you go, you're going first, mate. Okay, so you jump in the R500, yep. Get yourself mic'd up and do your thing, and then we'll see who's the fastest boy and who's the fastest car.